So, if you've been active in the RPG or gacha game community in the past year or so, you may have heard of a little game called Genshin Impact. If so, have you ever wondered about the science behind the electro element? If you haven't heard of the game and you're just here for the science, let me give you a little rundown of the part of the game we'll be discussing today. In Genshin Impact, you run around completing different quests, and along the way, you'll fight random or not so random enemies with different abilities, including physical attacks and elemental attacks. One of these elements is called electro, and going by the name, it's pretty much what you would expect. A fantasy video game weaponized version of electricity. Once you've been exposed to electro damage by enemies, lightning strikes, or even electro crystals, you get the electro status temporarily applied to you. If certain combinations of elements are applied, then reactions can occur, like melt, which is the combination of cryo and pyro, which is ice and fire. Of course, you can apply these elements on enemies too, and take advantage of reactions to deal extra damage. This is done by either infusing your weapon's attacks with elemental damage, or, in the case of magic catalyst users, inflicting pure elemental damage. Either way, it seems like you need to somehow summon the element spontaneously from within. Back in the real world, we have stun guns and tasers, which 1. Use electricity, and 2. Are very painful. It's been described as feeling like your brain's being shaken like a peanut in a jar, bees crawling in your skin, and horrific electrical current just flowing through your body. However, these actually work via direct contact. For example, conducted electrical weapons like tasers work in their probe or dart mode by firing 2 hooked or barbed darts connected by a wire onto their target, which causes severe pain and loss of voluntary muscle movement. Basically, instant paralysis by completing a 50,000 volt circuit with, well, your body. But is there a way for electricity to travel through the air without making direct contact, like certain electro attacks? Actually, yes. The US Army has developed a weapon called a laser-induced plasma channel, or LIPC, which basically fires lightning along a laser beam. An ultra-short pulse of high energy causes the electrons of air molecules to be stripped off, which forms a stream of plasma in the air. This makes for a pretty appealing path for the lightning to be conducted along. In other words, it follows the path of least resistance, which means that you can shoot electricity in any direction you want. Now, this is sounding more like Genshin electro attacks, where you can generally aim where you want the electricity to hit. And in Genshin, electro isn't that difficult to achieve once you have a vision. But if you want to recreate the LIPC in real life, you would need to be able to recreate both a 50 billion watt laser beam and the lightning itself, which seems like it would be kind of hard to achieve without the $700 billion budget that the US Department of Defense gets. Also, we have another obstacle. When the current flow of our homemade LIPC stops, that electricity won't stay in your body. The key to the way that electrocution works is that the electricity is flowing through some kind of circuit, entering and then leaving your body quickly. This means that the electro status in Genshin, where you or an enemy gets afflicted by electro on its own for some period of time, isn't quite realistic for the way that things work in real life. The human body won't store electricity. But wait a second, how does electricity by itself even cause us pain? It's because of how your body functions in the first place. All living animals have small electric signals in their nerves and muscles. It's how your heart beats, how your brain sends messages, and how you perceive sensation. When you get shocked, your nociceptors or pain receptors respond to all the electron movement going on, and your body becomes aware of the pain. Your skeletal muscle gets activated by the bombardment of electricity, isolating the neurons from your central nervous system and causing you to lose control of your body. This can cause additional problems, like being unable to cushion your fall to the ground and potentially suffering a concussion. To see an example of how electricity can hurt, let's take a look at electric eels, an animal whose defense mechanism is a painful electric shock. A fully grown electric eel can deliver about 600 volts in a shock. And to put that into perspective, standard household current in the US is 120 volts. A new eel species discovered in 2019 can deliver an even more shocking 860 volts. When one of these suckers, or any big enough electric jolt, hits you, it can cause muscle spasms, cardiac arrest, internal organ burning, nervous system damage, and other nasty effects. Electric eels were first classified by Carl Linnaeus in 1766. They became a big inspiration for scientists like Alessandro Volta, the namesake of the volt and inventor of the voltaic pile, which is a precursor to the modern battery and based off of the body of the electric eel. Fun fact, electric eels aren't actually eels, but they're more closely related to knifefish. Until recently, it was thought that electric eels were all one species. But in 2019, scientists found that there are actually at least three different species, and they named one of them Volta's eel. Going back to Genshin Impact, you can also combine different elements to deal more damage via elemental reactions. One of these reactions is called electrocharged, and it's what you get when you combine electro and hydro, which is the water element in Genshin. Electrocharge applies repeated electric damage to the target as long as it's in effect. So, is this reaction realistic? Sort of. A conductor is a material that permits the flow of charge or electric current to go through it, and water is a much better conductor than air. This means that anything that is wet will facilitate a much smoother ride for the electrons in a circuit, rather than just trying to move the electrons through the air. YouTuber and self-proclaimed failed mythbuster Alan Pan has actually prototyped and tested a water stun gun, where the electricity is conducted down two streams of water that has been made salty and thick by adding table salt and xanthan gum. So that's a relatively attainable example of using water plus electricity in an offensive device. As for spontaneously generating electricity just from within our body, which is what would appear to happen when catalyst users deal electro damage, we can look again to electric eels. The reason they can spontaneously generate electricity is because they have electric cells in their bodies. You might be thinking, yeah, sure, you just told me that we all have electric signals in our body. But the cells I'm talking about are electrocytes, which in electric eels are stacked by the thousands to form electric organs. These cells are the basis for the eel's famous electric shock. How it works is that the eel's nervous system releases the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, which coordinates an activating signal that causes the electrocytes to fire off in a chain reaction, each cell also activating its neighbors, all within about 2 milliseconds, resulting in a jolting shock. What's interesting with electric eel shocks, and part of why it's thought that they don't shock themselves and their own vital organs, is that they're submerged in water, so their electric shocks are weaker because it's distributed into the water around them. But an eel can actually jump out of the water to attack a predator by activating its electric organs and pressing its head against the threat. This makes the shock more effective than just staying in the water because they're conducting through their target rather than losing the discharge to the surrounding water. There's a lot more to talk about with electro and Genshin, such as thunder spheres, electro barriers, and shields, and how life imitates art or vice versa. But maybe the most pressing question is, electro buff when? Okay, I'm not being serious. At least in real life, where electricity seems to have plenty strong effects already. Point is, even though we can't pick up a book and shoot electricity from our fingertips at will, widely accessible technology inspired by video games is not as far from reality as we might think.